welcome to the Shelly Studio, and this is my mission inspiration for January. It's part of the Facebook group. I'll put the link in the description box below. Last year they were doing 10 prompts. I think this year they're doing 8, and then some color suggestions and some word suggestions. So the colors were a couple of shades of blue and some yellow. So I decided to take one of my travel brochures and cut out everything blue and just collage it down for the first prompt, which was torn fragments of advertisements, right? Yeah. Anyway, so I get brochures a lot and I've just been kind of hanging on to them. So I thought I would just use that and put down anything that I had that was blue or had blue in it. So you probably don't need to see me glue every single piece down, so we're gonna skip to the end of this part. There we go, I left a few spots, but it's okay. So the next prompt was to add strips of ribbon or trim, and I had a bow that was on a Christmas package. And it had this kind of meshy stuff on there and a little ribbon. So I thought I would just glue it all down and see what we can come up with. I was thinking it's a little bit messy, but the next prompt is gesso. So I thought maybe once I got these stuck down, I could gesso over them and they would just create texture. So that is the plan. So here I'm pulling out the gesso, and yeah, the prompt was cover with gesso or paint, so we're gonna gesso the page. I added a little water to keep it kind of thin. We want to see a little bit of that background. I'm not sure if we see any of that background in the end, but you know, it's all part of the process and texture. And there wasn't, you know, I'm still following the prompts because it says add paint, so we're just going to add paint and make this more colorful. And two shades of blue, yeah, following the prompts. The gesso didn't cover that mesh quite as much as I was hoping it would, so it's kind of hard to paint on. Still makes for an interesting sort of texture. It'd be interesting to get like mesh and cover the whole page. I don't know, that might be doing too much. So since most of those advertisements were for was from a cruise line, and it just made me think of the water and the ocean, and so that's kind of the idea I'm going for there. So I was too eager to put marks on top of that mesh and wasn't paying attention to my list. So that was number 7, make marks, and it was a little out of order. And now we're doing number 4, which is add secret journaling. I'm not very good at like decorative, scribbly handwriting. So I was trying to scribble. So some of it is legible, but most of it, I don't even think I was making words, I was just scribbling. But the first part was talking about how I love the ocean, blah blah blah, you know. So the next one is add a focal point or image, and so I decided to really get this looking like we are at the ocean. Those needed to be pillars, or hose that come out of the water, you know, for a dock. Yeah, that's the word. You can tell I don't live by the water. Okay, so I'm adding a rope around the pillar, and then we're gonna glue down the rest of the rope. Now I've got a few more things I've cut out of magazines that I thought would be good. I've got a sailboat. And a goldfish. Not exactly what you'd see in the ocean, but it was fun. Bright orange goldfish. And these round things are supposed to be those glass buoys. So, and I just used a hole punch on some patterned magazine pages to create some funky decorative buoys. And because of all the texture, they were a little hard to stick down. But I got him to stick in the end. All right, so now we're going to add a goldfish. The goldfish. I was trying to decide how I wanted him, but he needed to look like he was jumping. So I have him tilted a little bit. So the next part was add drips or splatters, so I decided to pull out my inks and do some blue splattering and try to have it look like waves on the water. Kind of obliterates the journaling a little bit more, but that's okay. I hadn't really written much. And then the last prompt was to add a border, so I decided to pull out my white. I think I'm using jelly roll pen, and it's not quite getting white enough, so I pull out my white Molotow pen and try to get it going. Takes a little while to get the fluid flowing, I think, on that thing. Once you do, it gets going pretty good. Felt like I needed to do more, so I put dots around it, just randomly. And then I decided my post isn't standing out quite enough, so I'm going around it with the Stabilo All pencil so that we can shade around it and make it stand out a little bit more. And both of them, because I did the stamping on the other side, so they look like two posts, even though there isn't any mesh on that side. Decided to go around the boat just a little bit. The Stabilo All. It's so much darker than my general sketch and wash, but it surprises me every time I do it. I put a little and then I touch it and it's so dark. And we do it around the fish too. And so I thought I'd pull out my white pen again and put in a few highlights and have to add a little bit of journaling. Just let the sea set you free. There you can see the texture of that mesh. Looks kind of cool, doesn't it? My little goldfish. So I hope you liked that. If you did like it, please hit like, feel free to share and comment, and if you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.